Hello, welcome to our MOOC again. We're about to start week 6. So far we've been dealing with steady state problems, but in the real world, in many cases, stuff is transient, so we have to deal with that over time things will change. In week 6 we'll concentrate on that and we will use again conduction and diffusion only, but now deal with changes in time of temperature and mass. And we will see how we describe it for short terms and long terms. Enjoy this week. We've got a good question about heat transfer through a cylinder wall. This is our Nusselt number, 2 over the natural logarithm, outer diameter over inner diameter. And the question was, what will happen if these two become very close to one another so that the thickness between them is small? Then intuitively you would say this has to go back to a flat plate. And can I show that? And the answer is yes. Out of this Nusselt relation I can make the h, which is 2 over say the outer diameter and the lambda and the logarithm here. Now I'm going to write that this is thin-walled. Say it has thickness delta. Then the outer diameter is close to the inner diameter, d1, and they vary by this thickness, yeah, but twice, also on the other side, 2 delta. And thus, I can write here that this is 2 lambda over d1 plus 2 delta, multiplied by the logarithm, d2 over d1 is 1 plus 2 delta over d1. All right, if you know your math, then you know that this is, if delta gets small, about 2 delta over d1. The logarithm boils down to only this number. And if I fill that in, I got my 2 lambda, d1 and d1 here, they disappear, so this is a 2 delta. 2 delta, 2 delta here over d1 gives you 4 delta squared over d1, which is much smaller than that one because delta is much smaller than d1. And thus you find that this is 2 lambda over 2 delta, the wall thickness, the 2's go out, and lo and behold, you're back with the flat plate. Very good question, and very good to see that this is a consistent scheme. We have another point that I'd like to discuss with you, and that has to do with how do you make a complex problem manageable? How do you cut it in pieces? And importantly, how do you take out small, unimportant parts? And as a good example, let's look back at your hot room and the cold outside, or if you live in the tropicals, it's hot outside and you want to stay cool inside. We have been discussing already that heat will flow from hot to the cold part. And we see that in principle we have 5 resistances. There's one sitting here, there's one in glass here, then there is in the air gap, this is double glazed, there is glass again here, and there is resistance on the outside. We've done the exercise where we ignored the 2 on the outside and we only looked at the 2 from the glass plates and the air. And if you compute it, you will find that way too much heat is lost. These 2 really matter. Now you can reverse this knowledge and say, well, if these 2 matter, obviously the air gap here should matter, otherwise people shouldn't make double glazing. So I could scratch out the resistances here and work with 1, 3, and 5, and number 2 and 4 are gone. You don't have to. You can take them all into consideration, but in many cases it pays off to take only the leading terms and simplify your problem. Once you have done that, you can always go back and convince yourself that these indeed don't matter. This is an important way of dealing with transport phenomena. Many problems are so complex that if you don't cut them back to their essentials, you will drown in all the details. Try this yourself and always convince yourself that if you scratch out, that they are small. If it turns out they're not small, you have to put them in back. Good luck.